Hello friends, welcome to learn Microsoft Excel. Today we are going to learn very interesting part, conditional formatting. We know how to format any cell or any data in Excel. Now let us see conditional formatting. For using conditional formatting, here we have some data, some numbers, some text data that is grade and some date. Okay. Now where is conditional formatting is located? Go to home. And here is you have condition formatting tab. Okay, the first one is highlight cell rule. After before that you have to select the range, go to conditional formatting, and suppose here I choose greater than. Okay, here by default it will take 80. Suppose I change this value and I use here suppose 90. Now here is the conditional formatting, because it will condition or it will format the cell that are satisfy this criteria. You can, if you don't like this formatting, you can here it will give you choice. You can also choose here different formatting. Okay, and if you don't like all this formatting, then go to custom format and you can choose your own back color and own font color. Okay, like this. These cells are these are formatting. Now suppose here I change this value, this is 10, but suppose I use here 110, then also this cell is gets the same formatting. Okay, like this you can either use greater than, less than, between, equal to. Like this you can choose any of the formatting as per the requirement. Now the next part is text that contains. For that purpose, we have to select this range, go to conditional formatting and choose the text that contain. It will by default contain first. Suppose I don't want here first, I want to use third, then there is third. Two times third is appear. Now if I want to use second, then there is second. Like this you can also formatting the given text. Okay, suppose here no grade is become second, then also it will get format. Like this you can also give formatting to date. Here date occurring, suppose I want to format the yesterday date. Okay, now the yesterday date is 27, today is 28. Now if I want to format the tomorrow date, then there is tomorrow date. If I want to format this week dates, I want to format last week date. I think there is no, there is last week. If I want to format last month as well as this month. Okay, suppose again if I change this date and instead of it there is 7, then it will get formatting. Okay, you can also clear all this formatting. Suppose here I want to clear formatting, then go to select this range, go to clear rules. There is no need to select the range, go to clear rules, and here you can see you can clear rules from selected cell. Here the cell is selected but there is no rule, then I want to clear all the rules for entire sheet, therefore click on here. Okay, after that one more thing, if you want to find the duplicate values, then these are duplicate values. No grade is not is a unique value, but this option is of duplicate value, then also you can select here unique value and give the formatting. You have duplicate value as well as unique value. Okay, like this you can format the duplicate and unique value. Okay, after that suppose I want to format only top 10 items. Here this range has the top value is 150. Suppose I select this formatting, top 10 items, all data are selected because I have only 10 items. Suppose I reduce this number. I want to top 4 items. These are top 4 items. I want top 5 items. Then these are top 5 items. Like this you can select. I click on cancel. As well as top 10 percentage. Okay. Suppose I want increase the percentage 20, then there is suppose 30, then 40, then 110 is selected. Like this you can increase the percentage. As well as there is option bottom 10 items, like top 10 items you can also choose bottom 10 item, bottom 10% above average. Now here I selected all this range and average is show at the taskbar at the status bar. Whole average of this range is 86. Suppose I want to select the cell above average, format the cell above average, only red text, as well as you can also select the cell below average. Okay, like this you can set all these two formatting. The next option we will see in next lecture. You have to do it because it is very simple and interesting task. Here we have a limited data, but you have a hug number of data, then this option is very useful for searching a particular data. Okay, thank you for watching the lecture. We will continue in next lecture.